in a very, very positive way, the Student Rec Center has made a great impact. I think one of the things that's really important, it's really changed the life and the landscape of the campus.
Our students were very vocal about what they wanted in the facility and the feel they wanted it to have, specifically that kind of warm, welcoming, an extension of the student union, a place where you can come and hang out, a place for everyone, not just athletes or people that want to get into shape, but a place where you can come and do other things like hanging out at the pool or play ping pong or just hang out and study. And there are some spaces that were really designed well to accommodate that.
The real potential of a student recreation center and how it can become a critical part of a student's kind of experience at the university, it starts with the opportunity to be a recruiting tool. In the 120,000 square feet, there's rock climbing walls to recreational pools where you can swim in laps, but you can also drag your furniture in the pool and watch movies at night. Of course, all the facilities from weightlifting and the different studios that have kickboxing and spin classes and all that, indoor soccer, three very large kind of basketball courts. So just an amazing kind of variety of types of spaces. But I would say probably the most important role that the Rec Center plays on campus is the main social space that really supports an active student life on campus.
Making that program fit on that site was one of the key design challenges for LPA. And the solution that we ultimately came up with and built with the gymnasiums, the tall volume spaces on the second floor, elevated rather than on the first floor, was really an effort to address the issue of fitting that much program into that site and staying within the context and the scale of the campus, not having a 60, 70 foot tall building adjacent to much, much lower buildings. And that wouldn't have been possible without a really carefully integrated architectural, structural, and mechanical solution.
We were considered a commuter campus because the majority of our students drive to campus. But a lot of them now come back to campus or stay on campus longer in the evening and come back on the weekends to actually partake in the things that we offer here in the Student Recreation Center.
And now we are seeing our students come and stay and hang out and eat. Our food service units are staying open later to support that. We're seeing a lot of higher foot traffic. A lot of more people on their bikes moving around the campus. In fact, we had to expand our bike parking to be able to support those needs.
The project funding was very unique, and I think one of the big stories behind the project itself, the state actually didn't have money to pay for a facility like this. So the students took matters in their own hands.
Our students actually led a campaign to inform students about the process, and we came up with a graduated fee increase. So students actually voted to tax themselves over a period of time to actually finance the project.
I like that they have multiple gym areas. They got one on the right side, one on the left side, and then even if it's super busy, there's one upstairs so that I can always find something to use.
I really like the rec center. I feel like it's another dimension of campus for students to go do things. Whereas before, I feel like if I wasn't in class, I was at the library and I was gone after that. But now, this added element, you can play basketball, you can hang out with your friends, you can meet up, meet more people this way. So I really like this part of campus. It's I feel like it's brought a lot more people here, and it's good.
Students love technology. They want everything to be, you know, state of the art. So this Lutron lighting system that we have here that actually, you know, senses and harvests the amount of daylight that we're getting in the building, and therefore decreases the production from, you know, a number of our light fixtures, and kind of balances that out is really neat. And their eyes light up. They're like, wow, you guys have really put a lot of thought into this process. Most recreation centers that you walk into, you're going to expect to see these big, large ductwork in the ceiling and all this stuff, you know, for your HVAC that's, you know, pushing out or harvesting, you know, the air. But in here, you don't see that because it's all integrated into the second floor. And so that we're not, you know, we're not trying to push that air down. We're allowing it to do what it naturally wants to do and rise up.
working with LPA to design a building that has flexibility into it was just phenomenal. Our opportunities to make changes to the facility in the future was really just a direct result of LPA's hard work and careful consideration when we were talking to them in the initial design phase.
Putting the gymnasiums on the second floor had real structural engineering ramification for the sizes of the structural members in between the levels. And then locating the mechanical equipment not on the roof of the building, but in roof wells sitting on that same second level, and distributing the major ductwork beneath the floor of the gymnasium in a displacement ventilation system. It was a combination of design decisions there between architecture, planning, structural, and mechanical that really allowed the building to take its form, to fit on that site, and to fit on that site in a way that's in scale and consistent with the rest of the campus.
When we first started the project, we wanted the building to be in a different place, but we didn't really have a large enough footprint to actually achieve what we wanted to, so we looked at alternate locations. And just having the integrated design allowed us to do that with all the players in place at the very beginning of the process. The other challenge from a design perspective was the length and size of this building. It's longer than a football field. So if you look at that, how do you design it in such a way that it is still aesthetically pleasing and functional? And I think integrated design and LPA was able to achieve that for us.
The Northridge Recreation Center is a really good example where those design decisions, rather than being made in series, were really made together. So decisions about how the massing of the building would come together and how the structural system would work were made in conjunction with also how the major mechanical systems would fit into the building, would be distributed through the building. So each iteration of how those decisions were made was much more tightly coordinated and integrated, if you will, and that led to better architecture, better structural engineering, better mechanical engineering than a more traditional model where those decisions are made more independently of one another and more in isolation from one another. Thank you.